السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back my friend to my YouTube channel Drilling and Workover. This is Abdelaziz Gabr. I am accredited instructor in IWCF Well Control and IEDC Well Sharp. I am also accredited instructor in IEDC Mud Engineering for Basic and Advanced Mud School. Today, inshallah, we will talk about very important and also very complicated topic, and it is very important due to the course. Okay, it's called the clay chemistry. Why are we study the clay chemistry? Actually, if you need to know that the different types of the mud are used according to the clay or the shale percent in the oil in the formation. Why? Because the shale, most of the problems that happen to us while drilling is in the shale or the clay. So that you have also another thing, that if you need to take some parameters in the mud or another or some solids that comes to you in the mud, it will be through the shale. Through the MBT, if you check the MBT, we'll check for the clay. And also, if you need to make a high gel strength, or you need to increase the gel strength, you will add some bentonite. So that it's very, very vital and very important to know how the shale, what are the types of the shales, and the swelling mechanism, and the dispersion mechanism, and the other interactions with the clay. So I know this is a very complicated topic, but I hope inshallah I will make it as simple as I can inshallah, and you will get it easier. It will be in two lessons. So this is the first lesson today. What we will talk about, we will talk about the clay definition, okay, the clay nature, and the basics of the clay chemistry, and the types of clays, and then the clay interaction, and how the swelling occurs, and the clay problems also. Okay, clay. What is the meaning of the clay? Actually, determining the type of the clay and its reaction will help us to understand the way of inhibition for it. For example, the type of the clay, you cannot know the type of the clay without making the X-rays and without make complete diagnosis for it. But we have the most common types that we are talking about. And once you get the high MBT in the test, this means you get active clay. And this means that you will talk about one of the types that we are talking today, inshallah. But you cannot know exactly which type of the clay we are dealing with unless you make the X-ray to make good investigation for it. Clay minerals are classified as layers, okay, or layered silicates, because the dominant structure consists of layers formed of sheets of silica and alumina. Actually, each crystalline or each particle of the clay consists of octahedral and tetrahedral silica and alumina, so that we will talk about each one of them. That's it. As you see here, this is tetrahedral. As you see, it is like the pyramids, and the octahedral, it's like the box, okay? And as you see here, this is one unit layer. This is one unit layer in the crystal lattice, okay? So clays, nature, clays are usually either of two layers, okay, two layer types, like the kaolinite, for example, or three layer types like this. This is three type layers, okay? One layer silica, another layer alumina, and another one is silica. So this is a three layer type, such as the most of them, the montmorillonite, which is the most common one, and we use it in making the spud mud, and also to get the gel strength. It's called the bentonite or montmorillonite, and the chlorite or illite and semictite and the other types. So the kaolinite has two layer types only, but the other types consist of three layers. And as I told you, silica, alumina, silica, or it can be of different. It can be more silica or more alumina according to the arrangement of each crystallite. Each plate like clay particles. Each particle consists of a stack of parallel unit layers. That's it. Okay, this is the unit layer, and there will be another unit layer here and another unit layer here. So each particle of the clay consists of a stack of parallel unit layers. And each unit layer, this is the unit layer, okay? Each unit layer is a combination of tetrahedral, like the pyramids, okay, and arranged silica sheets, and octahedral, which is eight faces, arranged alumina sheets. This is silica and this is alumina inside them, okay? So this is how the structure from the unit until to the particle and to the crystal lattice. As you see here, okay, by making the shape of them, you can see this is aluminate or alumina in the middle, and this is silica, okay, in the top, and there is another silica on the bottom, okay? So according to the arrangement that happens to even the alumina or to the silica, okay, to the silica or to the alumina. For example, if we make substitution for the alumina with Mg, alumina is +3, okay, but Mg is +2, which means that there will be extra electron, okay, so it will give negative, it will be negative, and it will make adsorption or something like this for the cation. We will talk about this later, inshallah. Also for the silicon or for the silica, okay, if it has some substitution for it with others, it will make also another interaction. So according to the substitution, whether of alumina or silicon with Mg or Na or something like this, the charge or the outer charge of the crystal lattice or the unit layer, it will be negative or positive according to the situation. But most of the clays or clays can be either electrically neutral or negative. Neutral or negative according to the situation of the substitution. Okay? Also, it depends. So here, as you see, this is layers. This is alumina, for example, and this is silica, and this is silica, alumina, and silica. And here there are shared oxygen bonding. Okay, this, as you see, this is oxygen. Okay, this is oxygen. Okay, and this is hydroxyl. Okay, hydroxyl, and this is hydroxyl also. And this is magnesium or aluminum according to this, and the silicon. This. Okay, they are bonded together with oxygen. With oxygen layers or with oxygen bonding. Okay, they are. As I told you, they are, okay, if we check here, also this is oxygen and this is oxygen. So they are here, as you see, related to each other with the oxygen bonding or oxygen, as you see here. Also, the OH is the, on the outer surface. The OH is on the outer surface. And also, it helps to make the bonding between the each unit layer, okay? According to the pH of the formation or the pH of the mud, if the pH is very high, okay, is high, this means that the outer layers here will become negative. And if it become negative, there will be no interaction or no too much interaction. But if the pH is not high, but for example, it is 8 until 9, for example, there will be great reaction with it because it is positive. Okay, so take care of those 2 points. The clay plates, let's reaction, as I told you, the charge on the edge will vary with pH, as I told you here, the charge on the edge or on the body. But we are talking here for the edge, for the edge, okay, for the edges, okay. It depends on the pH. At low pH, the edges are more positive and it's active. What's the meaning by low pH? It means it's no more than 9, no more than 9. But at high pH, the edges are more negative or become non-active. That's why for bit bowling, when we need to deal with the bit bowling, we are making a caustic bell as a first action in order to make the shell around the bit to be non-active and try to solve the bit bowling around the bit. So at low pH, the edges are more positive and or active. At high pH, the edges are more negative. And as I told you here, low pH here means 9 or sometimes 8 or something like that. Okay, but not less than 7, for example. Drilling fluid clays. The types. What are the types of the clays? Number 1 is called illite. Number 2 is called chlorite. Number 3 is called the kaolinite. Number 4 are some mixed layers of each of them. Number 5 is called atabulgite or sibulite. This is the same meaning. And finally, which is the most important one, is called the montmorillonite. Okay? So the illite, it's a blade-like, non-swelling, which means that if it is non-swelling, it cannot make a great problem for you. Okay? So it is non-swelling or slightly swelling like illite. It's found in the formation. What are the properties of illite? This is very important. The illite has a substitution of alumina for silicon. Okay, so if we check for this here, this is silicon and that has it changed with more alumina. Okay, so the silicon is plus 4, but alumina is plus 3, which means that there will be a negative charge. This negative charge on the outer surface can be compensating. Okay, the compensating cation are primarily the potassium ion. For example, there will be extra negative, and in order to become stable, it has to get something to be positive. Okay, so something positive. Sorry, to be neutral. So what is the positive cations? Maybe Na, maybe K, maybe something like this. But in this type, which is illite, the K is compensating for this negative charge, and it's called the potassium. And take care, the spacing between unit layers is 2.8 angstrom, okay? And the K, the ionic diameter of K is 2.66 angstrom, which means it is less than the spacing between the layers, or mostly they are roughly they can be the same. Okay, this is 2.66 and this is 2.8, so it comes in between them and snugly fitted between the two layers. This allows the K to fit snugly. Okay, between unit layers, snugly means it is fitted by force and cannot get out again. Okay, so this K positive cation of the potassium to fit snugly between the unit layers, forming a bond that prevents the swelling in the presence of water. Okay, as you see here. This is, for example, a unit layer, and this is another unit layer, okay? And this is K, for example, the K from the KCl or from the formation, while forming this type of the shale. This K comes here between the two layers, and as you see, its shape is less than that of Na or Mg or Ca, so it is fitted snugly here. And they cannot move, this cannot move, and this cannot move, and there will be no swelling. That is why the illite cannot swell or has a bad swelling properties. Number two, the chlorite. Number two, the chlorite, which is a three-layer clays. In this clays, the charge compensating cations between unit layers are replaced by a layer of octahedral magnesium or hydroxide, which is the brucite, okay? Octahedral magnesium hydroxide or brucite. This layer has a net positive charge because of some replacement of Mg plus 2 by alumina plus 3 in the brucite layer. As I told you, the silicon has been it's replaced by alumina. And now the magnesium instead of alumina, this gives a net positive charge. And this net positive charge don't cause significant problem unless present in large quantities. And also it is non-swelling, as you know. Okay, it has low cation exchange from 10 to 40. This is very important. The third type, which is the kaolinite, it has two layers of clays. This is very important. The kaolinite has two layers of clays. It is non-swelling clays at all because it has in its unit layers bounded tightly together by hydrogen bonding. By hydrogen bonding, this is very important, as I told you. This prevents any expansion of the particles because water is unable to penetrate the layers. Number four, the atabulgite or salt gel. Atabulgite is not common and it is not on the full information. It is just made by MI, for example, a company, in order to be used in the offshore or in the deep water, because you cannot get too much fresh water on these locations. So we make the salt gel or the atabulgite. Its properties, it is not found in the formation shale, okay? It is non-swelling in the fresh water. It exhibits very poor filtration properties. It is used as a viscosifier for salt water mud, as I told you. So the atabulgite or sibulite, it is used only in the salt water, and it is not common type of the clay. Number five, the mixed layers. Mixed layers can be more than one clay mineral, such as, for example, montmorillonite and illite, illite and kaolinite, chlorite and kaolinite. Number six, which is a very important one and which is the most common one, it's called montmorillonite or cimectite. This has the same meaning. We have two types. Number one is the calcium type, okay, calcium type, which is a blade-like, slightly swelling. It is in the formation. It is found in the formation shales. So if you see any montmorillonite while drilling, this is calcium type, calcium montmorillonite type in the formation shales. There is another type, it's called montmorillonite sodium type. The sodium type, it is the same like bentonite that you are adding to the spud mud or to the fresh water. So sodium montmorillonite is added to a mud to increase the viscosity and to increase its, reduce the flow drop reducer, and especially it is added for the gel strength, for the gel strength. Okay, so this is the most active one, is the sodium type. What's the composition? If just one atom of magnesium is substituted for one atom of aluminium in the lattice structure arrangement of the atom, it will then possess surplus electron or negative charge. If we make for the aluminium, it has substitution with Mg, for example, there will be a surplus electron or surplus negative charge. This negative charge is not stable, so it needs something positive to make balance. So it searches for the positive, it makes adsorption. The net negative charge is compensated by adsorption to the surface. Adsorption is only on the surface. Adsorption of cations, which is positive ions on the unit layer in order to keep to be balanced. This can occur by Na plus or Ca plus plus or Mg plus plus. So this is very important, but the most common is Na plus for the bentonite and Ca plus plus for the montmorillonite. As you see here, if we replaced the alumina with Mg, here also with Mg, okay, there will be a surplus negative charge, and this surplus negative charge will be compensated by adsorption, so it is surface bonded cations, which means adsorption, by the cation of positive, which is Na, and to become in balanced. It's become balanced at this type, and for this, this is the bentonite or the montmorillonite. This is general shapes of all the types of the clay. This is illite, as you see here. This is a unit layer and another unit layer, and between them we have potassium. This is chlorite. This is a unit layer, and this is another unit layer, and between them we have MgOH2, which is brucite. Okay. This is kaolinite, as you see. This is only two layers, as you see, just two layers. And it is fitted together with high hydrogen bonding, so it's also non-swelling. Here the swelling type is the montmorillonite. As you see, this is the type of montmorillonite. And this is the salt gel type, which is the sibulite or needle-shaped clay or a tabulgite. And these are the mixed layers, as you see here in its shapes. Very much. Thank you very much, my friends, for this lesson. And inshallah, I will talk with you about the swelling mechanism in the next lesson. If this video appeals to you, share, like, subscribe. This is your channel, not mine. And I hope, inshallah, to give you the best, inshallah. Thank you very much, and goodbye.